Here we presents the top 5 best Samsung laptops. Starting at number 5, Samsung Chromebook 3. In this guide we're looking at the Samsung Chromebook 3, and if you should buy one. Samsung is a name that won't have escaped anyone, except perhaps for freshly arrived travelers from a distant planet, but the company is more known for its smartphones and TVs than laptops. But Samsung does make notebooks, of course, including Galaxy-branded models and other Windows products, as well as Chromebooks. We're focusing on the Samsung Chromebook 3 here, which, like a fair number of the laptops running Google's Chrome OS, is a budget product. In fact, this is a very cheap Chromebook, which is one of the big attractions here, and it's also extremely portable too. That's mainly because the notebook runs with a very compact 11.6-inch screen, and not only is the footprint of the overall device small as a result, but it's impressively svelte and lightweight. Remember that this already low-priced Chromebook may well be further reduced with Black Friday discounts, and indeed we've already picked out a great offer in our best Black Friday laptop deals. We'll be constantly updating that page, so it might be an idea to keep it bookmarked to learn about the top offers on all notebooks as they happen. This is quite simply one of the best cheap laptops you can buy, and a sterling Chromebook in terms of being highly portable, somewhat rugged, with a good level of battery longevity. There's lots to like here, even if the screen is pretty small, and not the best quality. For more information and price, check out the product links in description. At number 4. Samsung Notebook 7 Spin. The Samsung Notebook 7 Spin is one of the best 2-in-1 laptops we've used in a long time, but in 2018, the firm behind it decided to switch things up a bit. What was a 15.6-inch, value-packed powerhouse of a hybrid laptop is now just 13.3 inches, and, while lacking power in the graphics department, is more sensible in size and scope. This is a bit of a shame, but it's not like other device manufacturers, even Apple, Google and Microsoft, aren't pulling the same stunt. Then, there's the more mainstream Lenovo Yoga 720, that manages to undercut the Samsung Notebook 7 Spin by $50 in the US, for pretty similar hardware, down to the same CPU, display resolution, storage and RAM. The model we tested, though, still has last year's Intel CPU inside. Samsung made this laptop thin and light enough to fit in a backpack with little notice, but it won't be winning any awards in either category, and it doesn't seem to have ever intended to. This is a basic hybrid laptop for both performance and pleasure. And, it's even a far cry from last year's model in terms of style. For instance, the Samsung Notebook 7 Spin measures just 13.3 inches diagonally, rather than 15.6 inches. Secondly, its frame is comprised of a much darker and not ice gray aluminum and two sturdy hinges, rather than the single hinge design and silver aluminum shell of last year. Samsung has drastically changed its Notebook 7 Spin year over year, crafting a 13.3-inch that's sublime to use in some places and baffling in others, making for a laptop we'd be fine with using for a long time, but which isn't exactly award-worthy. Halfway of my listed number 3. Samsung Galaxy Chromebook. The Galaxy Chromebook is in a class of its own. Forget about it being a Chromebook, you won't find another laptop this thin with so much performance, regardless of what OS it runs. Add a 13.3-inch, 4K AMOLED display, and it's easy to see why the Galaxy Chromebook is a boundary-breaking machine, not just for Chrome OS, but for the industry as a whole. The bright and saturated AMOLED panel lives up to the billing. Only the Galaxy Chromebook's gorgeous metallic red chassis could stand up to what is one of the best laptop's displays we have ever tested. This is the thinnest Chromebook ever, at just 0.4 inches thick, but if the slim frame doesn't catch your eye, the laptop's Fiesta Red finish will. The metallic scarlet finish pops in a way I've never seen before on an aluminum device. It's a bold design that wouldn't have worked if Samsung hadn't spread the magnificent shade across the entire laptop. The touch bit, keyboard and even the hinges bleed the fiery hue. I'm also a fan of the laptop's chrome edges, which are a nice contrast to the lovely ruby tone. Samsung also sells the Galaxy Chromebook in a mercury gray color variant, but trust us, you want the red. Samsung clearly sweated the details. The laptop has a notch on the front lip to help you open the lid, and the webcam is located on the thin bezel above the screen. I also like how the arrow keys are offset, which makes them easy to find by touch. If you won't leave the Galaxy Chromebook unplugged for long periods, then there is no better Chromebook. But if you travel frequently, or just don't like being tethered to an outlet, then then save some money and get the Pixelbook Go instead. In the end, I still want Samsung to make a Windows 10 version of the Galaxy Chromebook because it's only one fault away from being the best laptop on the market. For more information and price, check out the product links in description. Coming in at number 2. Samsung Chromebook 4. Chromebooks are getting bigger and more premium all the time, but a lot of people still just want a cheap way to get online. That's where the Samsung Chromebook 4 comes in, succeeding the well-liked Samsung Chromebook 3. This system is worth a look for students as it landed on our best laptops under $500 page, but it doesn't hit high enough highs to land on our list of the best Chromebooks and laptops with best battery life. While the Samsung Chromebook 4's battery life is good, and its price is on the lower end, the laptop's 11.6-inch display isn't bright or colorful enough. Also, this laptop features a non-touchscreen display, so you can't touch Android apps from the Google Play Store. There's still a lot to like about the Samsung Chromebook 4's affordable $229 price, long battery life and decent performance, but you should consider some alternatives before buying this machine. The Samsung Chromebook 4 comes in two sizes, the $229 11.6-inch model we tested, and the $259 15.6-inch Chromebook 4 Plus, the bigger brother, with thinner bezels. For $50, you can upgrade the internal storage and memory from 32GB and 4GB to 64GB and 6GB. The Samsung Chromebook 4 looks exactly like you'd expect from its low price. With curved edges and a silver hue, the Samsung Chromebook 4 looks a lot like the many MacBook copycats we've seen over the years. Its aluminum top feels a little nicer than I expected, but the laptop's price shows in the plastic body. This machine's chunky display bezels make it look even more aged, but I don't feel like you should expect more for a laptop that costs less than $250. If you want a system with a better screen that still has decent battery life and solid performance, the Lenovo Chromebook C330 is right for you. Yes, it costs $50 more, but it's also got a touchscreen, which the Samsung Chromebook desperately needs. But if you want a Chromebook just for Google Docs and basic web browsing, the Samsung Chromebook 4 is worth a look. And number 1. Samsung Galaxy Tab S6. If you're looking for a tablet to get work done, Apple's iPad Pro line or any number of 2-in-1s probably come to mind. But don't tell that to Samsung, which is hoping you'll pick up its Android-powered Galaxy Tab S6 and a $179 keyboard case to satisfy your productivity needs. The Tab S6 is an undeniably powerful tablet with top-notch build quality and hardware. Unfortunately, that same care doesn't transfer over to the software experience, which proved quite buggy in testing. And Google Play simply can't keep up with Apple's App Store when it comes to creative apps for professionals, making the promise of productivity here a relatively empty one. The front of the tablet is dominated by a 10.5-inch Super AMOLED display. Resolution clocks in at 2560 by 1660 for 287 pixels per inch. The AMOLED display is gorgeous, with deep, inky blacks and rich colors. Color accuracy is excellent, and the screen is bright enough to use in any scenario. Although the Samsung Galaxy Tab S6 is a gorgeous tablet with stellar specs, its software keeps it from being a true competitor to other pro-minded tablets and 2-in-1 devices. If you're looking for an alternative that has access to the Google Play Store, check out the 2-in-1 Samsung Chromebook Plus V2, which features a stylus, some of the best hardware you'll find in a Chromebook, and excellent service and support from Google. Content creators will want to consider spending more on an iPad Pro, which works with many creative apps like Adobe Creative Cloud that you won't find in Google Play. And if you simply want a tablet for multimedia consumption and gaming, the $329 base model iPad is an excellent choice. I have included these product link in the description. You can check out this link for more information and latest price. Thank you for watching this video. Please hit the like button. Share with your friends. And be sure to subscribe.